We are pleased to welcome an Acrocanthosaurus to the park. Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to welcome an Albertosaurus to the park. To the park. Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to welcome a Charybdisaurus to the park. Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to welcome an Edmontosaurus to the park.
The gigantic Spinosaurus you have here doesn't quite live up to its name. Don't get me wrong, it's big, but manageable. Just watch out for those shoulder blades. They'd ruin anyone's day.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to welcome
It's dinosaurs like this, from a Jungasaurus, that can really be a handful. It's short, stocky, and lives for the hunt. This is also one of the only dinosaurs we know of that may have engaged in cannibalistic behavior. Nothing like having your friends over for dinner.
What can I say? The Indominus Rex remains my most inspired creation. Nature can create a dinosaur, but only I can bring an Indominus Rex to life. To do so required a tremendous amount of research, gene mixing, splicing and manipulation, and, of course, determination. The end result is a hybrid dinosaur that is both beautiful and deadly. An alpha predator among alpha predators. So treat it with the care and respect it deserves.
Well, what have we here? It's an Amargasaurus, according to the paperwork I have in front of me. Another interesting factoid. Its long neck meant it probably liked to feed on the taller branches of trees and such. At least that's what it says. Guess we'll find out, huh?
This massive specimen is called the Apatosaurus, an impressive animal that can intimidate even the most determined of predators. The Apatosaurus' evolutionary advantages are its size and its demeanor.
Another massive animal, the Diplodocus was once considered the longest animal that ever lived. And now, thanks to our extensive research, it's back. My task is to make sure we learn everything we can about this dinosaur. Your task is making sure these magnificent creatures can survive in the modern world.
Personally, I don't think the Troodon gets as much respect as it should. It's one of those dinosaurs that seems like an evolutionary bridge, stuck in time and transition. The platypus of its day. And now? Ours. It's also incredibly interesting to study and display, so make the most of this animal.
Now this dinosaur, the Dracorex, is something strange. Its name means the Dragon King of a fictional school for wizards. I think I could have come up with that myself. The name, not the dinosaur. For that, we need the scientist. Now, stay with me. This dinosaur is called a Carcharodontosaurus. Talk about a mouthful, right? And seeing that this animal is an alpha predator, its mouth is usually full of the slow, the weak, and the inattentive. Hence the reason I'm not getting near it. You, on the other hand. Now, here's a funny little dinosaur. Correction, a pretty decent-sized one. It's called a Cintalosaurus. The T is silent, like the P in swimming. Yeah, and it has a mohawk. At least, that's what I'd call it.
Okay, this is amazing. A Baryonyx. These animals have very large claws on their first digit. This dinosaur also likes water, so Take a moment to consider its needs when planning out a suitable habitat for it. The Baryonyx was originally thought to be a scavenger, but now, with live animals to study, we can find out for sure.
Let me introduce you to the Metria canthosaurus. Say that fast 3 times. This is another alpha predator that, while not as big as some of its cousins, tends to stand more upright. So I guess it has good posture while it's tearing you to shreds. This animal, though an herbivore, can intimidate most predators with its size. It's a biggie named Dreadnoughtus. I'd give this dinosaur a wide berth.
Just when you think you've seen it all, along comes the Therizinosaurus. Believe it or not, those huge claws you see, they actually help to feed on vegetation. For real. But, just do me one favor, okay? Don't let it near my hair with those things.
Now this dinosaur is something special. Well, they're all something special. But this one stands out because of the horns on top of its head. It's called Ceratosaurus. It kind of looks like a slightly smaller T-Rex, but its bite is probably about the same. There isn't a more iconic dinosaur than the T-Rex. Even people who don't know the difference between herbivore and carnivore know all about the Tyrannosaurus Rex. And when you see her up close, feel her gaze, you understand why the T-Rex was the ruler of the Cretaceous period.
Okay, so this next dinosaur, the Parasaurolophus, has a flair for the dramatic, especially where its head is concerned. It has a distinctive cranial crest, which is used for added resonance in its vocalizations and to regulate its body temperature.
Soft spot for this dinosaur, the Velociraptor. And they get a bad rap as far as I'm concerned. But if you imprint early enough, you can make real connections with them. Other than Claire, raptors are the most intelligent partners I've ever had. And like her, they can kill me in the blink of an eye. That's a joke.
Do I want the dinosaurs to fight? No. But do they want to fight? For some, it is what they were born for, what they live for, and what they're willing to die for. That is a purity that few humans have. Whenever a dinosaur dies, I feel like I've lost one of my own.
Yeah.
Yeah.
On route to collect the asset. Asset requiring collection. Asset collection request received. Transportation underway. Asset transportation in progress. Heading to collect the asset. Thank you.
Acknowledging asset collection request. Asset in transit. Transported. Heading to pick up the asset. Collecting asset. en route to pick up the asset. Asset has been collected. Asset. En route to pick up the asset. Heading to collect the asset. Transporting asset. Asset transportation underway. Commencing asset transit. Asset transportation in progress. Asset delivery confirmed. Confirming asset delivery. Transportation complete. Asset in transit. Asset to be collected. Transportation underway. Mm-hmm.